A transistor is a semiconductor device used to amplify or switch electronic signals and electrical power. It is composed of semiconductor material, usually with at least three terminals for connection to an external circuit. A voltage or current applied to one pair of the transistor's terminals controls the current through another pair of terminals. Because the controlled output power can be higher than the controlling input power, a transistor can amplify a signal. In this video, we will learn about transistor symbols, pins, construction, operation, and their advantage and limitation. Transistor symbols and pins. Transistors are fundamentally three-terminal devices. On a bipolar junction transistor, those pins are labeled collector, C, base, B, and emitter, E. The circuit symbols for both the NPN and PNP are shown. The only difference between an NPN and PNP is the direction of the arrow on the emitter. The arrow on an NPN points out, and on the PNP, it points in. Transistor structure and operation. Transistors are built by stacking three different layers of semiconductor material together. Some of those layers have extra electrons added to them, a process called doping, and others have electrons removed, doped with holes, the absence of electrons. A semiconductor material with extra electrons is called an n-type, N for negative because electrons have a negative charge, and a material with electrons removed is called a p-type for positive. Advantages of transistors. No cathode heater. Reducing power consumption. Eliminating delay as tube heaters warm up and immune from cathode poisoning and depletion. Very small size and weight, reducing equipment size. Large numbers of extremely small transistors can integrated circuit. Low operating voltages compatible with batteries of only a few cells. Circuits with greater energy efficiency are usually possible. For low power applications, example, voltage amplification, in particular, energy consumption can be very much less than for tubes. Complementary devices available, providing design flexibility, including complementary symmetry circuits, not possible with vacuum tubes. Very low sensitivity to mechanical shock and vibration, providing physical ruggedness and virtually eliminating shock-induced spurious signals, for example, microphonics in audio applications. Not susceptible to breakage of a glass envelope, leakage, outgassing, and other physical damage. Limitations of transistors. Silicon transistors can age and fail. High power, high frequency operation, such as that used in over-the-air television broadcasting, is better achieved in vacuum tubes due to improved electron mobility in a vacuum. Solid-state devices are susceptible to damage from very brief electrical and thermal events, including electrostatic discharge in handling. Vacuum tubes are electrically much more rugged. Sensitivity to radiation and cosmic rays. Special radiation-hardened chips are used for spacecraft devices. Vacuum tubes in audio applications create significant lower harmonic distortion, the so-called tube sound, which some people prefer. Dear sir, thanks for watching the video. For more updates, please subscribe to our channel, Learning Engineering, and to get notifications, press the bell icon.